Whether it's a Beech Baron, a Piper Archer, or the Phenom, private aircraft ownership gives you the freedom to go where you want, when you want. Well, sort of. Unfortunately, an aircraft isn't something you can just store wherever you want. And of course, many need a couple of thousand feet of land just to get in the air. Usually this means storing your aircraft at a local airport or flying club, which could be anywhere from several minutes to several hours away. But what if your hangar was part of your house? And what if you could taxi from your hangar to the runway? Well, if you could do that, then you're probably living in an airpark. This is Heaven's Landing, a fly-in community in the mountains of northern Georgia. Based around a 5,000-foot private runway, Heaven's Landing is a developing community designed for anyone who wants to not only own an airplane, but also be minutes away from taking off and going wherever they please.
At Heaven's Landing, the runway is your driveway.
Mike Cicchetti is the developer and manager of Heaven's Landing. He initially found the site by accident, but immediately knew that it would be the perfect spot for an airfield.
Kind of a metamorphosis. Initially, back in 1992, I discovered the property kind of on accident. A 635-acre tract that was here that I didn't actually know about because it's surrounded by national forest. I lived a few miles away, and I had a bull and a few cows, and they escaped my pen and came over and cross-grazed here on the pastures that are now Heaven's Landing. When I saw it, I said, wow, it'd be amazing. You know, you could land a plane there. Lo and behold, 9 years later, I signed a big contract, decided to put a deposit down on that property that was then available, and turn it into a fly-in estate. I actually had plans to have a fly-in community for myself. Got in an accident later that year and had a bad shoulder injury, which detoured my career, and I ended up turning it into a fly-in community for the masses, and we've done pretty well with it.
Heaven's Landing is a relatively new development. There's just a smattering of luxury homes built today, but Heaven's Landing has plans to accommodate over 170 homes in the airpark.
We've got 14 homes so far, and it's roughly 50-50 as far as full-time, part-time. The great clubhouse here that we just completed a year ago, and it's a social centerpiece for all the fly-ins, Super Bowl parties, St. Patrick's Day, Easter brunch, Easter egg hunts, that kind of stuff.
It sounds like a great community center. What other sort of recreational activities do you have available?
On site, we have racquetball, fitness center, steam and sauna in the locker rooms, and hiking, biking, fishing, you name it. It's a great area. We're surrounded by national forest, yet the beautiful part about it is that we're only 3 miles from downtown Clayton, so it's only about a 7-minute ride to gourmet restaurants, a grocery store, all the things that city life has to offer. You have the best of all worlds.
This is a fly-in community, so the big attraction is, of course, the flying. And the North Georgia mountains are the perfect backdrop no matter what aircraft you're in.
We have everything from steermans to citation. We're lit. We have a Pappy. You can come in here, you know, all hours, day and night, safely. We have a real eclectic group of pilots and group of aircraft, great people.
Another beautiful day.
A young group, too. That's what's nice. We have people that are real young at heart and people that are just real young. And it's nice that we're not just an old folks flying community. We're a happening folks flying community.
One thing that's clear is that this happening community loves aviation. If the sound of airplanes taking off grates on your nerves after a while, you might want to look at other options. However, one of the unique features of Heaven's Landing is that not all of the lots are directly off the field.
Probably one of the things that's unique about us relative to other client communities is that because we're mountainous, not all of our lots are taxable. But that's what makes this place so beautiful. You can have a mountaintop lot and views of three states and have a hangar on the field a minute or two away that you own, that you have all your private stuff in. The other thing that's nice about that is when you have social parties, that kind of stuff, you can have your party in your hangar, and if they spill wine on your floor, you go, oh well. They do it on the carpet at home and it makes people upset.
Now, of course, taking the plunge and living at an airpark is not a financial decision to be taken lightly. Heaven's Landing, like many airparks, is a gated community. And to match the mountain settings, there's also a design standard that all homes need to conform to.
Well, we have a 2,500 square foot minimum requirement on the homes. We call it a mountain elegant decorum, so it's a nice combination of wood and stone. You have to use all natural products, no vinyls or aluminum. So.
For Heaven's Landing resident Tom Nasser, this decorum worked out perfectly.
I purchased a lot up here at Heaven's Landing about 1 year ago with the intentions of maybe building in 5 to 10 years, waiting for the economy to get better. Well, guess what? I don't know if it's getting better or not, but you only live once, and I made the decision with my wife that we're going to build our dream home, and we wanted to do a log cabin. Everything's coming along great. We're hopefully be able to move in August of this summer, which is great.
The mountainous location has not only affected the homes. Mike has taken a lot of care to develop Heaven's Landing so that it fits in with the surroundings and seems less like an airfield and more like a community. The terrain has posed some challenges, though. The runway is sloped, which may seem odd to non-pilots, but is quite common and completely safe. Also, the construction of the hangars was impacted by both the terrain and the community design style.
We have limited flat space at Heaven's Landing, so we took advantage of what flat space we have and a little bit of the slope. We actually did a two-story hangar concept where our hangars are stacked on top of each other. It's never been done before. I've had a lot of people inquire about doing it since. They've asked us how we did it, and then when they figure out how much it costs, they seem to back away because it's not a cheap thing to do, but it was a very, very exclusive thing, and they turned out great. We did them with standing seam roofs, Wilson bifold aluminum doors. They have a 6-12 pitch, so they have a look that is non-hangar-esque. We wanted them to look more residential or equestrian stable-like to give them a feel that was residential. We're not an airport, we're a flying community, and I don't want this place to look like an airport, and we've done the best we could to keep it that way.